来宾午安，欢迎莅临前瞻趋势论坛气候变迁驱动的永续转型东亚新契机活动，现在正式开始。首先让我们代表主办单位欢迎各位的莅临，一同关心台湾的永续发展与转型。首先让我们邀请贵宾致辞，先欢迎台大社会科学院院长王宏仁院长为我们致辞。
Director Zhou and Director Lin and our honored guests and ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the College of Social Sciences at National Taiwan University. As you may know, our college is the top, or may I say the number one, research and education institute of social sciences in Taiwan. And many of our college members not only make contributions to academics,but also provide expertise and advice to the government to assist the policy making. But their efforts has always been on an individual basis. So about 10 or 15 or even, I can say, 20 years ago, when Taiwan began to face a new round of challenges and problems, we began to realize that we, the academics, need a new approach, a new paradigm,to assist the government and to respond to the new challenges. And for example, the economic problems can no longer be resolved by economists alone, although I'm an economist. So the new paradigm asks for the multidisciplinary collaboration and the public engagement. We came to this realization because, for example, we saw that a cross-trade problem with mainland China.It's as much as an economic issue as it is a social and political issue. And the energy problem that we face today cannot be reduced to a simple benefit and cost analysis. So we need collective efforts. We need people from different disciplines to work together to provide a viable solution. And so today's host, the Risk Society and the Policy Research Center was born out of this conviction. And under the leadership of the former and the current directors, and especially the leadership of Dr. Zhou, I think that the center has become a very influential platform in Taiwan for intellectual communication and for public engagement. It also has a very good international visibility.And today's event is only one of the many events that the center hosts every year on a regular basis. So finally, I'd like to take this opportunity to let everyone know that the College of Social Sciences not only fully supports the mission of the center, but we also try very hard to bring a multidisciplinary collaboration, a centerpiece of the college's research and teaching. And in fact, some curriculum reform is currently underway.And we are confident that our next generation will be equipped with a broader view and a broader skill set, which will enable them to face the ever-increasing challenges in the future. Thank you.
谢谢王院长。再来，让我们欢迎台大国际产学联盟主任林博文主任为我们致辞。欢迎林主任。
王院长、周教授啊，各位贵宾还有叶先进啊，下午好。
然后，
台大国际产学联盟是成立还不到一年的一个单位啊。那我们成立的主要目的是帮助学校里面的老师跟产业界做对接啊。那我们在这半年多来呢，雇用了大概20位的具有产业经验的产业联络专家啊，来帮助学校里面的老师。将他们的研究成果啊变商品化啊，所以只要是学校里面的老师啊，以及学校的研究成果啊，跟产业对接或者是非营利组织对接啊，都是我们的工作啊。那目前来讲，我们已经招收了44个知名的企业啊，成为我们的会员啊。那很多的会员跟我们反映说，现在台湾的企业碰到很多的这个挑战啊，其中一个挑战就是创新转型啊，还有越来越严苛的这个法规，以及越来越挑剔的顾客，以及对于很多的投资人呢，他们不光期待公司能够获利，而 而且能够希望企业能够善尽对地球的这个责任啊，所以面临这样的一个挑战啊，我们把它视为一个机会啊。那就如同刚才院长所谈到的啊，就是说需要一个跨领域的团队啊来回应这样的挑战，那也把它视为是台湾产业再一次创新转型的一个契机啊。所以非常荣幸有机会能够跟这个社科院这边啊一起来协办这样的一个论坛啊。那我知道参加这次论坛的一些贵宾啊，都是相当有经验的学者啊，还有政府的官员以及企业的领导者啊。那借用这个机会啊，来共同探讨我们所面临的个问题，那同时擘画出未来我们可能的一些创新的机会啊。因此，作为国际产学联盟办公室啊，我们非常期待呢，能够持续的跟各位能够合作啊。那也在此预祝大会成功啊！那各位的讨论能够非常的丰硕啊！那谢谢各位。
谢谢林主任。想要提醒在场的贵宾，请将您翻译机的音量稍微调整小一点，以免干扰到其他的观众。谢谢。好，接着我们将场次交给主持人。台大风险社会与政策研究中心周慧田主任来主持接下来的场次，谢谢，欢迎周主任。
Good afternoon, everyone. So, first of all, our new teams, Professor Pang Hong and Director Lin, you have given us of the open speech. So, today afternoon we have the sessions.Towards sustainability transition driven by climate change, the case in this Asian country. We are very honored to invite three speakers. The first speaker is Professor Koichi Hasegawa. Professor Hasegawa is a professor in the Department of Sociology, Graduate School of Art and Later, Tohoku University, Japan. And he is a very famous environmental sociologist and engaged a lot of affairs in the International Sociological Association. And he also very assist Taiwan to join the International Academy Network. So, and we actually also have very close cooperation with the issue.Climate change and energy transition. And our second speaker is the Professor Dong Wang Gu. Professor Dong Wang Gu is now a director of the Environmental and Society Research Institute, so South Korea. He is also the former director of the Environmental Sociological Association.South Korea. And Professor Gu Dongwang also very intensively observed the progress and the structural problem of energy transition and climate governance in South Korea. So I think he will give us a very substantial speech to introduce the development and the problems.Energy transition or sustainability transition in South Korea. And our third speaker is Professor Leo Abayao. And Professor Leo Abayao is the director of the Cordillera Study Center, University of the Philippines, Baguio. And Professor Leo Abayao also engaged in the disaster governance very much. Last year, I heard her speech, discussion about the disaster management related to climate change governance. So I think she will also give us very progress development of this kind of things in Philippines.So overall, we will have the pictures from the three countries, and we have the fourth We have the first speaker, the Professor Li Hejin. Li Hejin 教授, Professor Li Hejin is now is the professor of the University, Central University, and the Department of Politics. She will come later.
So now
you
have
the
pictures.
那我们先邀请贵宾一起合照。
So now we will have the first speech by Professor Koichi Hasegawa. His title is Climate Change and Energy Policy in Japan. And every speaker had 20 minutes for giving a talk, and later we had 10 minutes for discussion.